Hey guys, what's up? Today we'll be talking about the API console. With the API console, you have quick and easy access to all functions of the REST API, which allows you to play around and debug issues. And this is done without writing a single line of code, so you can ultimately build your apps faster. The API console is a super easy way to test different functions through the dashboard. So let's get straight to it and see how it works. We will need to log into the dashboard and navigate to the API console itself. Here it is. With the API console, you can do a couple of interesting things. You can create, update, and delete objects. You can run requests as a specific user of your application. This is usually done to test your ACLs and COPs, by the way. You can also call your cloud code functions and start background jobs. And last but not least, you can export calls to C URLs. This is very useful when you want to change something in your function through terminal without logging into the dashboard. In order to make a request, you just select the endpoint of the API you want to hit. Optionally, you can enable usage of the master key. This is where you'll be able to do it from. Or a user to run the request as. The result will be displayed immediately for you to inspect. So let's check our current cloud code. Here it is. Let's go to the functions.js file. We have a function right now, which is hello. And the result it should return, as you can see, is hello from SashiDo simple cloud code. Let's test this function and see if it actually works. We'll go back to the API console. We'll choose type of request, which will be post. And then the endpoint will be functions slash hello. We'll click on the send query button. And here is the result that we are getting. Hello from SashiDo simple cloud code. So as we can see, our function is obviously working. Let's return to our cloud code now and manage it on GitHub. What we are going to do now is change something in our function and then we'll test it again and see if it is working. If you remember in our previous video, we have discussed cloud code and how you can manage it on GitHub, so probably everything right here is already familiar to you. So let's go to the cloud folder, then to the functions.js file and click on the edit this file button right here. Let's change our function from hello from SashiDo simple cloud code to hello from SashiDo's video series. We just apply the change that we need, then we scroll down and click on the commit changes button. As soon as we do it, the deployment process starts and we'll see a message right here in the dashboard as well. If you remember from our previous video, I mentioned that it takes a couple of minutes to complete the deployment. So let's leave it for now and return back and see what has happened. So a couple of minutes have passed and we are back. Let's see if our change has been successfully deployed. As you can see, now our function result should be hello from SashiDo's video series. Now let's go and check if this function is actually working. We'll go back to the API console again, we'll choose type of request, it will be post, then again we'll need to choose the endpoint, in our case this will be functions slash hello, and we'll click on send query. The result that we are getting is hello from SashiDo's video series. So obviously our function is working. That was it basically, folks. As you can see, it's super easy to use the API console and it will help you a lot. Next week, we will be talking about webhooks. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button and thanks for watching. See you next week, guys. Bye-bye.